Hello, Equinox.
Hola.
Hola. So can you already say something in Portuguese? Yeah?
Boa tarde.
Boa tarde.
Nós chamamos
Lisboa. Vocês amam Lisboa.
Obrigado.
Obrigado, obrigado também.
Obrigado.
Obrigado.
Bom apetite.
Bom apetite. Yeah, you're supposed to say that when you're actually going to eat. Just now, okay. So bring the food now. Guys, thank you for coming. You have such a great energy. And we can see that on stage, right? How did you feel? First rehearsal? Do you feel comfortable enough? Is there room for improvement? How are you feeling?
Oh my God, it's great. Actually, the stage is insane.
Thank you.
Yes, congratulations about it.
Thank
Good
you.
Job. Our first rehearsal was so emotional, and we're feeling so happy about it because everything was fine. And yeah, thank you for having us here. We're so happy to be here.
Thank you. So you're okay with the stage? Everything is going fine for you? That's good to know. So as a group, you didn't meet such a long time ago, right? For about a couple of months that you know each other. So are you already like a big family, or do you feel comfortable with each other also?
We are already a huge big family, and we love each other, and we feel so comfortable with each other, I think. Everyone can see that on the stage.
It's definitely. I've said it before in interviews, I'm an only child, and it wasn't until I met them that I felt like, I have like brothers and sisters. Like, honestly, I can't imagine my life without them.
Great. Your stage designer is Sasha Jean-Baptiste, and she did this role. Okay, let's applaud Sasha. How was it? How was it working with her?
Oh God, it's so amazing. I had the pleasure of working with her, actually witnessing her work with Christian Kostov last year in Kyiv, and she was so amazing. And she's an amazing director, choreographer. She knows all about the stage. She's a complete professional, and we're so lucky to have her.
I think that she's the best one for our performance.
True. Yeah, she was the best choice.
Oh my God, absolutely,
she's
incredible. Absolutely, 100%.
Because she's done such a great job of making it feel like it's staged, but also that we feel like individuals. So she's just been absolutely brilliant.
So Bulgaria is obviously on a golden era on Eurovision, and so you were fourth 2 years ago, then second last year?
Yes, and it's because Symphonics International.
Big shout out
to Symphonics International. So it's, how was it also to work with Wojislav, and how did it all go? The song?
He's really nice guy. He's so talented, first of all. I think that all of us, we're so happy to have him because he's such a creator. He put us together because we know each other before. And we're here with the most really powerful thing that he can do. So, yeah.
And you, Trey, you participated actually in the creation of the song. What can you tell us about Bones?
Sure. So again, Boris Lob's brain is so incredible. He just has the most incredible ideas, and they feel so organic. So we actually wrote the song together, and he was like, "I have this amazing idea," and I was like, "Oh goodness, knowing Boris, I'm like, what have I gotten myself into?" And he comes back and he's like, "I think this song is amazing. I think it would be great for Eurovision, and I have these other vocalists that I think would be incredible." And here we are today.
And what was your reaction when you heard it for the first time, Johnny? What did you feel when you heard the song?
I actually fell in love with it. Not all the voices were on when I first heard the song. There was just one, and I fell in love with the song. And when I heard the concept behind creating a record with five voices, I thought there was no better choice of song to do that with, especially because the message of the song is, you know, love and unity, and so I felt like that was very appropriate.
So I guess it wasn't very hard to convince you about the message of the song because it's so powerful and so universal that
yes.
That you can see also that on stage. Thank you for that. Okay, we're opening questions to the audience, and we're going first to Bulgaria. Can you stand, please, and can we have a microphone here?
Thank you. Hello everyone from Equinox.
Hello.
It's Madeline Tutelian from Eurovision Bulgaria, and my question is for Johnny and Trey. So for the past 2 months, you've constantly been working and also spending time with a lot of Bulgarians. And my question is, do you have a favorite Bulgarian word, phrase, or a song that you could share with us?
So I'm going to be that person and say that rakia is definitely my favorite Bulgarian word. Definitely my favorite Bulgarian drink. I think the first phrase that I actually learned before hello was obechem rakia.
Fair enough. I understand completely. I would learn the same. Yeah. Okay, here in the front, can we have the microphone? Thank you. I think we're live somewhere.
Hi, Alicia Michelle. I'm here with ESC Extra. And my question is, what is the best piece of advice someone has given you about competing in the Eurovision Song Contest, and who was it from? So anyone can take that.
To have fun and to enjoy the stage, actually. Because we've met lots of great people here from the other countries, and we are so happy to be here. So just to have fun, to present us to the best way we can. So that's, yeah, I think this is the...
I think one of the best advices I've heard was breathe. Here at Eurovision, it's simply breathe. It's a huge stage, and when you're going up on that stage, you need to breathe. And you need to remember that. So, yeah,
it seems to be quite common with all the artists, like Ari from Iceland also taught us a bit how to breathe, so it's obviously a valuable lesson there in the back.
Hey guys, WeLogs.com. This is a question for you guys to kind of ask each other in a way. So, look to the person to your left, Vlado to Johnny. You guys have great chemistry. Describe one word that describes the person next to you the best.
Okay, nice game. Thank you.
Very nice. Should I start?
Yeah, go for it.
Kindness. Johnny? I think.
So I'm saying fabulous.
Euphoria.
Euphoria?
Yes. Johnny's euphoria for me.
Love.
Okay, this is an emotional moment here. We just witnessed, very nice.
I would have to say rock. Like, Vladdy, you're like so consistent and so calm always. When everything is like moving so quickly, we can always like trust in you to be like steadfast.
Thank you for that question.
Thank you, that's very interesting. Okay, here.
Hi guys, Stephen Cork from ESC Daily. Your performance today was very dark, mysterious, this indie kind of vibe. And then you just said your song is about universal theme of love. What did you do to make sure that the performance doesn't get too cold while your song is about such a warm topic?
I think for sure it's not cold, our performance. Actually, we really, really want all of you to feel that love. But we live in a dark place, like the earth, in comparison with the universe, so that's the reason we start so dark at the beginning. So, yeah, but it's about truly the dream love.
I think it's really important that even though it does start a bit dark, our performance on stage, it's really important to sing from the heart and really show that emotion and try to reach out to the audience and connect with people. And also, I think it's really important that it shifts from darkness to light towards the end of the song. And that's really what the message is about. So hopefully we can touch you with our performance.
And I guess there's a lot of warmth in the way your voices blend together, you know?
Absolutely.
Can you give us a little hint of your song a cappella here? So that we hear how beautiful it is when you sing, well, when the five of you sing together. Thank you. Okay,
City, Bulgaria, JP for Wake International. I would like to know, like you've performed for the Eurovision Song Contest, the participation, will you be staying together afterwards as well? And how did you find each other? And how did you come up to the main Equinox? Three questions, I'm sorry for that.
So how do we start?
Well, I can say that Equinox will definitely stay together even after the contest, if you have a vision. And actually, Borislav Milanov is the guy who made us a group, so yeah, we're Equinox now.
Yeah, we chose the name. Actually, Boris was looking for the right name for the project. And it first circled around this obvious idea about the fifth element, if you can see that from the way we look together. And but it he started there, but he developed the idea, and he was looking for the right name. And we had many different options we discussed, but I think it's his search. He's always searching into the spiritual and godly themes and. You know, I'm not going to say religion, but I'm just saying the spiritual side of things. So he, through another name that he was exploring in another concept, he came across Equinox as a phenomenon, a natural phenomenon. And he thought that this is the perfect name for us because this is what we represent. We represent different people from, even we're from different continents here, but we have the same message and we have the same love. So that's pretty much it.
Thank you. Trey and Johnny, did you guys hear before about
April.
Your... Sorry.
Yeah. I was just saying this is because we are all equal.
No matter how different we look to you, so we are equal. All of us are equal, and that's the most important thing.
That's a good message. I was asking if you heard about Eurovision before coming into this project. Did you know it back in the US, or you had no idea?
So I had heard of it before because I'm primarily a songwriter. So a lot of my friends are actually in the competition as songwriters. A couple of the Swedes before I left the States, and they were like, oh, you're competing against us. I'm like, sorry about it.
I have a lot of friends back in California, and so I heard about it in passing, but I didn't quite understand how big of a deal it was.
Until they got here.
Until I got here, yeah. And it's literally like nothing else I've ever experienced, and it feels good to be a part of the Eurovision family.
Definitely, yeah. And we definitely welcome you, so thank you for being here. Okay, then back.
Hi, Alistair Birch from Eurofile. I have a question for Georgi. I understand you organize charity concerts for special children. Can you tell us a little about that, please?
I'm a vocal teacher for 8 years and more, actually. And for me, it's really important to teach my students that we can help each other, actually. Because in Bulgaria, we have lots of charities, things, and concerts, and events and all, but people who do music have to know that, yeah, we are equal, actually. We have to be helping each other. That's really important. When somebody asks you for a pencil, just give him. It's just a normal thing. So I did a concert for children with a diabetes, cancer, and lots of children with diseases, actually. But yeah, we earn so much money to them and make their Christmas really, really happy and excited.
Yeah, I do think that deserves a big applause. Thank you. One last quick question. Anyone? Yeah, here. Also from Bulgaria?
Hello, my name is Michael, and I'm from EurovisionBulgaria.com. My question is to Jana, why did you decide to take that week?
Well, first of all, this is kind of a joke, but yeah. Well, I had to choose between black hair and other color. So then I decided that maybe, because on stage shows we're showing that we are coming from black to white. I decided to use white color, which I really love how it's sitting on me. So, don't you think, Michael? Well, so, this is why, because also the boys are calling me the universe in our group.
She's our brother, you know.
Yes. This is why. I decided to use white and black, because black is a little bit on the dark side.
She also has such an electric personality, this like white lightning here.
Yeah.
Matches her personality so much better.
Do you know where you can see her personality? You can see actually on all sorts of lipstick. The lipstick traces of Jana are there.
I can say that
face.
I know Michael since probably 5 years already.
Okay.
He's from my big team, Bengendorf's. Yes, this is why I jump on him like that.
Okay.
I'll contribute some like from the other side to them now.
Okay, so now we know. Equinox, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And you're great, and best of luck.